Okay, folks, today we have a 1989 Sea Ray Amberjack 27 footer. The hull is in extremely good condition, all waxed, ready to go. Our Hunter Green Bimini. We do have some covers that are brand new, three-piece covers in the Hunter Green also. Got three axles, tri-axle trailer. We got the radar stand with four rocket launchers and a deck light up there. The Ferrano antenna is not working. Got a trailer guide. Trim tabs. We have some new parts installed on both these engines. They're Mercruisers, 300 horsepower. Some new gimbal pieces and hydraulic line. New. Stainless steel props, very good condition. It does come with two spare props, stainless. You can see the gimbal pieces are also new on this starboard engine. We have a swim platform and ladder. Nice handle there to hold on to, get up board. Current name is D&D. We have a walk-through transom door. Trailer is a Owens & Sons all aluminum slide on. Looks to be in pretty good condition. Boat does weigh about 12,500 pounds when full of fuel. So you need something rugged to tow it. Owners installed a nice stainless plate here. It is a new anchor, new chain, and new anchor line. See our bow pulpit. Wood. Very large area here on the deck. few rod holders. We do have some wood. This boat does come with a nice stereo system and amp. Current owner likes to listen to music. We've got a courtesy light down there. Cup holder. Rugged tower here for the radar. Very nice shape. And we have our controls. All our gauges are working. We have our Ritchie compass. Windshield wipers. There's some side windows here to actually open up. Get a little extra air. Handle. This is kind of neat. It's a companionway door. Pass things through from the galley. Dinner and drinks. Companionway with door and hatch. Does have some older equipment on it, but some old Loran Sea Navigator, which being used. We have a standard depth sounder that is working. The autopilot is disconnected and owner has parts for it, but it is not working. Switches. We have our clarion stereo remote. We have our hour meters. Port one's at 1409 hours. Starboard one is 1445. It's got more hours on the starboard one when trolling. It's the 30 something hour difference. We got our trailer port and starboard controls. Get the tilt up the engines a little bit farther when you're getting on off the trailer. Quicksilver controls. Trim tabs. DC outlet. The cabinet here. It's got our radio, VHF. With an external speaker for the VHF, so you can hear the radio over the engines while you're cruising. There are the original seats. Got a little wear and tear on the corners of both. This is actually a bench seat that does fold out. And you can sit four people comfortably, five or six maybe if you're pushing it. Transom door. Let's take a look down below. And we've got our door to the head. We'll look at that in a minute. Large V berth area. We have a couple of fans in here. That's nice to have. Get a little extra breeze, but it does have AC and heat that are working. Got some hatches, our ports, portholes. Our faucet, our sink, our cutting board, some storage, drawers. Got a Norcold refrigerator, a little Sunbeam microwave, it's bolted down. This is the other side to our companionway door, which is nice. More storage. And here's our head. Does have a holding tank that you can be pumped out. This is the access to the wiring by the helm. Some storage. Mirrors. Sink. Okay, we have two 300 horsepower engines, Mercury, fire suppression extinguisher, halon. We've got new alternators on both engines, new belts. So once again we have our 1989 Sea Ray Amberjack 27 footer. Again, the hull is in beautiful shape, especially for 89. It's very clean, waxed. It's ready to go.